Have you ever gone through a day and at the end of that day you asked yourself, I wonder if God is really proud of me? Like, I wonder if I did something that God could actually be proud of. I don't know if other people think that way, but I do. So I wanted to create this video, and in this video I'm going to be talking about ways in which you can become a productive Christian. So keep watching. Hi everybody, welcome to my channel. My name is Rutendo Melody Kanguru, and this is a platform for women that are ready to partner up with God in intentionally designing the Christian lifestyle they love to live in, and a lifestyle that God can bless. So definitely this video is not going to encompass every single thing that you should do as a Christian, but I thought it was really gonna be fun for me to come through and share some ideas on things that you can incorporate into your Christian journey on a daily basis, or you could pick one of these things on a daily basis and practice them intentionally so that you can really be a blessing to the people that are around you. First thing that I thought of was intentionally sending someone a message in the morning, reminding them that God loves them. There's something very powerful about reminding people and drawing people back to their God, because you do not understand how many people go through situations and circumstances on a daily basis that really test their love for God, or their faith in God, or their faith in the fact that God loves them. So why don't you pick a person a day for a full week and just send them a message in the morning, remind them that you love them, and also remind them that God loves them. Second thing I want to encourage you to do is a small thing. It's just compliment someone. As you are walking into the workplace, compliment someone for what they're wearing. As you are in the grocery store, compliment somebody who's got a nice hairdo. As you are in traffic, just raise your thumb up and compliment somebody, even for giving you the way. I'm also going to encourage you to say a 2-minute prayer for your leaders. This could be your husband if you're married, it could be your local pastor, it could be your boss, it could be the people that really give you the canopy of covering wherever you're planted, or wherever you're serving, or wherever you're giving your services. Just pray for them, because whatever goes well with them goes well with you. Also learn to speak life over your future. I mean, this can really be embedded in any small act, as you're washing, as you're cooking, or as you're walking to the cafeteria from your workplace. You can declare over your life. You can say, I am the head and not the tail. I am above and not beneath. I am blessed of God. I am protected. I am covered. I am provided for. Speak into your present and speak into your future. Next thing, if you're watching this video and you drive, I want you to like this video. I need you to do something. I need you to smile in traffic. Yes, I know it's difficult. I know it's almost next to a miracle, but you have no idea how much a smile can literally just be a blessing to somebody, can change somebody's mood, or can actually allow somebody to revert back to you or give you a better response in any situation. Smile. I also want to encourage you to practice one act of kindness a day. It could be in the biggest of ways, in the smallest of ways, according to your capacity. Just make sure that by the time you lay down to sleep, you have been kind or patient with somebody. Next thing that you can do, which is I'm also becoming a very big supporter of, is exercise. Taking care of your body shows respect to God. It shows respect to the vision that God has placed over your life. It shows respect to the call of God over your life, because you're saying, I know I need this body to fulfill my earthly mandate right here on earth. So I'm going to take care of it because I know and I actually value the word that you spoke over me. Not only that, God resides in you. Like, take better care of yourself for the sake of Christ. Something that you can also do as a Christian is to have somewhat of an academic approach to your spirituality. Be intentional about your growth, whether it's in listening to sermons, whether it's in reading books that are going to be encouraging and edifying to you, whether it's in podcasts, because as you build up your inner capacity, it is so easy for you to manifest that throughout the day, in your responses to people, in the way that you handle people, in the way that you handle life circumstances. It is definitely going to add up, and it is definitely going to show. Finally, I want to encourage you to always have the thinking, what would Jesus do in any situation? So difficult. It's difficult for us to truly be like Christ, but if we're really going to do this thing and if we're going to do it right, then we really constantly have to ask ourselves, what would Jesus Christ do and how would he respond in the situation that I'm in? And despite all the resistance, despite all the antagonism that is in our hearts, we've got to try to be like Christ. Has this video been useful to you? If it has been, thumbs it up. Share it with a friend who you know needs it. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. And I cannot wait to see you in my next video. See you very soon. Very, very soon.